Next was, if n objects are arranged in a row, then number of ways of selecting three objects so that no two of them are next to each other is. Now solution. So there are n objects. From that we have to select three objects. Suppose we are selecting A, B and C in such a way that no two of them two next to each other. That means there are four portions: A0, A1 and A2 and A3. So we want ABC should be selected, that means A1 must be greater than or equals to 1. At least one thing should be there in between A and B. Similarly, at least one thing should be there between B and C. So A2 should be what? Greater than or equals to 1. And A0 can be anything. So A0 can be greater than or equals to 0. Similarly, A3 can be anything. A3 greater than or equals to 0. Now, sum of A0, A1, A2 and A3 must be n minus 3. So we can say A0 plus A1 plus A2 plus A3 must be n minus 3, where A0 is greater than or equals to 0, A1 is greater than or equals to 1, A2 is greater than or equals to 1, and A3 is greater than or equals to 0. So from here we can write A0 is greater than or equals to 0, A1 minus 1 is greater than or equals to 0, A2 minus 1 is greater than or equals to 0, A3 is greater than or equals to 0. So A1 minus 1 we can assume as A1 dash. So A1 dash equals to A1 minus 1. Similarly, A2 dash we can assume as A2 minus 1. So from here we can write as A0 plus A1 we can write as what? A1 dash plus 1 plus A2 we can write as what? A2 dash plus 1 plus A3 equals to n minus 3, where A0 is greater than or equals to 0, A1 dash is greater than or equals to 0, A2 dash is greater than or equals to 0 and A3 is greater than or equals to 0. So from here we can write as A0 plus A1 dash plus A2 dash plus A3 equals to n minus 5, where A0 is greater than or equals to 0, A1 dash is greater than or equals to 0, A2 dash is greater than or equals to 0, A3 is greater than or equals to 0. So solution of this equation is nothing but what? N minus 5 things we have to distribute into 4 parts. So we need how many partitions? 3 partitions. So n minus 5 plus number of partitions required is 3, c number of partitions. So this will come n minus 2 c 3. This is your answer. Next problem is, find the number of ways in which 10 girls and 90 boys can sit in a row having 100 chairs, such that no girls sit at either end of the row and between any two girls at least 5 boys sit. Now solution. So we want to arrange 10 girls in such a way that no girls sit at either end of the row and between any two girls at least 5 boys sit. So first we arrange girls, so G1, G2, G3, G4, G5, G6, G7, G8, G9 and G10. Now between these 10 girls there are a long gap, X1, X2, X3, X4, X5, X6, X7, X8, X9, X10 and X11. So according to problem, no girls sit at either end of the row. That means before G1 some boy should be present. That means X1 must be greater than or equals to 1. Similarly, after G10 some boy should be there. That means X11 also must be greater than or equals to 1. Next condition is, between any two girls at least 5 boys sit. That means X2, X3, X4, X5, X6, X7, X8, X9, X10 must be greater than or equals to 5. So we can say X2, X3, X4, X5, X6, X7, X8 and X9, X10 must be greater than or equals to 5. And sum of all the values of X1 plus X2 plus X3 plus X4 plus X5 plus X6 plus X7 plus X8 plus X9 plus X10 should be 90. Where X1 and X11 must be greater than or equals to 1 and X2, X3, X4, X5, X6, X7, X8, X9 and X10 must be greater than or equals to 5. Now for finding solution of this equation, we'll use multinomial. So we want summation as 90. That means we have to find out t power 90 coefficient in x1 min value is what? 1. So this we can t power 1. It can be 2 also possible. So t square plus t power 3 plus dot 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 dot. Similarly, x11 also minimal is not 1, so this will come same equation, so we can do square. Similarly, x2 mini value of 5. So this will come as t power 5 plus t power 6 plus t power 7 plus dot dot dot. Similarly, x3 mini value is what? 5. So this will come same equation. X4 also same equation will come, and x5, x6, x7, x8, and x9 and x10 will come same equation. So this we can put as power 9. So here we have to find out t power 90 coefficient. In if I take t outside, this becomes t square in bracket 1 plus t square plus dot 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 whole square. From here, if I take t power 5 comma, so they will get t power 45 in bracket 1 plus t square plus dot 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 whole power 9. So this we can write t power 90 minus 47 coefficient here to find out. In if I simplify, this is a GP series, this will come 1 upon 1 minus r, r is t whole square into, similarly this is also a GP series, this will come 1 upon 1 minus r, r is t whole power 9. So we have to find out t power 43 coefficient in 1 minus t whole power minus 11. Now we know in the expansion of 1 minus x whole power minus m, x power r coefficient is n plus r minus 1 c r. So t power 43 coefficient is eleven plus 43 minus 1 c 43. So this will come what? 53 c 43. So this we can add 53 c 53 minus 43. So this will come what? 53 c 10. So 53 c 10 will tell the number of way the boys sits between girls, but for total number of way girls can interchange by 10 factorial ways, then in between girls boys will sit by 53 c 10 ways. So this will come 10 factorial into 53 c 10. This is your answer. Next problem is, in how many ways two distinct natural number can be selected which are less than or equal to 100 and differ by at most 10. Now solution. So we want difference by at most 10. So according to method 1, first we will find out total solution minus difference between two number is at least 11. Now total solution. So total solution is, we want out of 100 number two numbers, so 100 c 2. So next we'll find out difference between two number is at least 11. So difference between two number is at least 11. So here we will select two numbers a and b. A and b divides the remaining number into two parts, x1, x2 and x3. We want difference between two numbers is at least 11, that means x2 must be greater than equals to 11. Similarly, x3 will be what? Greater than equals to 0, and x1 must be greater than equals to 0, where x1 plus x2 plus x3 must be equals to 90. Now we have to solve this equation. For solving this equation we will use multinomial. So summation we want 98. So we have to find out coefficient of t power 98 in x1 value will be at 0. So t power 0 plus t power 1 plus t power 2 plus dot 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 dot. Similarly x2 we want minimum value is at 11. So this will be at t power 11 plus t power 12 plus t power 13 plus dot 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 dot. Similarly x3 mini value is what? 0. So this will come same equation. So this we can do square. So we want coefficient of t power 98 in 1 plus t square plus dot 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 whole square. From here if I take t power 11 comma, so this will be t power 11 1 plus t square plus dot 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 equals to, we have to find out coefficient of t upon 98 minus 11 in, if I solve this one we will get 1 upon 1 minus t whole power 2 into this. If you solve, we will get 1 upon 1 minus d. So we have to find out coefficient of t power 87 in 1 minus t whole power minus 3. So coefficient of t power 87 is 3 plus 87 minus 1 c 87. So this will come out 89 c 87. So required solution is total is 100 c 2 minus 89 c 87. This is your answer.